dropping anchor is one I think is really good for that. So finding your comfortable position on the chair, and if you can just straightening up the spine a little bit so we are upright, and this helps with keeping us awake and aware. And if you have any back problems, just make yourself comfortable. You can sit back against the chair or adjust your position. And for this practice, it's great if you can close your eyes, but you can do it with eyes open. And actually, you can practice either way with mindfulness. And there are advantages to eyes closed and eyes open. So if you're happy, just closing your eyes and maybe just taking a moment just to feel that contact with the chair. And even this simple awareness actually is a useful tool when we are facing difficult emotions. So feeling that sense of contact, that grounded, robust feeling of the body actually shows our brain that we're safe, we're secure right now. And so that can be a useful tool if we do feel overwhelmed with any emotion, but particularly anxiety and uncertainty at these times. And then this first stage is acknowledge. So we notice what's going on in our body. We check the internal weather conditions. So what are we feeling? What are we thinking right now? So just noticing and actually naming it in your mind. So to notice and name something gives you a little bit of distance, a little bit of the observer position, which is really helpful with difficult emotions. Often we're fused, we're absorbed, we are not able to see anything else. So if we zoom back with this notice and name, that just gives us a little bit more flexibility. So it could be, here is anxiety, here is stress, here is boredom, here is frustration. I notice I'm having worried thoughts about the day ahead, about everything I need to do. I notice I'm problem solving, I'm worried about my work, my business, or my family. So whatever is going on, just notice and name it. We're not trying to get rid of it, we're just trying to build some extra space to hold this difficult emotion. So just scanning the body, noticing the mind. Thoughts can be images or words in your mind. So just noticing whatever is there. And then at times of high emotion, connecting with our body is so useful. So this second stage is to connect with our body. And this shows the brain that even in a difficult emotion, we can move, we can control our body. So if we're in the freeze or flight response, it shows we can control that stress, that anxiety. If we're in the fight, the anger or frustration, it shows that we are in control, even if we feel impulses to control, to act out. So whatever's happening, just to move the body is helpful. So here, just push your feet into the ground and feel that tension in the thighs and relax your legs. And then maybe just roll the shoulders a little bit. You could have a little stretch if you wanted to. You can circle the arms, you can rub the palms together. So finding a movement that you like, and you might have one already that you do when you feel stressed. So, you know, some people might massage their palms, or, you know, you might even just pace around a little bit. And actually at times, this is not a bad thing if we have a lot of emotional energy to discharge. To actually move can be more helpful than anything else. And in our life, this could be going for a run, it could be walking, it could be doing some bodyweight exercises, could be doing another mob class, yoga, any movement would be useful here. And then the final step is to engage with our environment. So this means just noticing what you hear around you. Can you hear three different sounds? Sounds far away, sounds in the room. And then opening your eyes and noticing three things you can see around you. and trying to have curiosity. So curiosity is a real support for concentration and for mindfulness. And actually, we're going to need curiosity more than ever as we're stuck in our homes for longer periods of time. So to actually not just be on autopilot, to look for differences, change and novelty, and to build curiosity into your routine. And, you know, what can we do that's different this week that will keep that curiosity going as we face living in conditions that we've not lived in before? So looking around you, and this is just a simple way to do this. Can you notice something different in your room and then roll that out into your work day today? Can you be curious about the people you're with and what you're doing and try and bring that level of curiosity? And it just really means looking for detail, looking for novelty, looking for change. And that can be such a support. So that last step, we're engaging with our environment and we're using all of these stages as an anchor in a difficult emotion, whatever that emotion is. And so I would say right now, if you're feeling a lot of difficult feelings because of what we heard last night, and what we wake up to this morning, to use dropping anchor quite a bit throughout the day. So acknowledge thoughts and feelings, connect with your body, engage with the environment. So ACE, you can remember that as ACE, as the acronym. So I would just be doing that, you know, anytime you feel an emotion is pulling you out of the present moment.